Hi everyone, my name's Kirby. Welcome to an episode of Mod Country, episode number one, the first one, the very, very first one. I'm very excited. I'm quite excited about it. I think that you should be excited about it too. If you want to see a little bit more about it, you can watch, I think I did one behind the scenes on Twitch, so you can watch that. But there's also, if you want more, there's also Mod City. And Mod City is Mod Country, but in the city. And with different people and different storylines. So, it's the same, but not at all. Yeah, my name is Kirby. Subscribe if you want more Sims. Okay, let's play. I'm so excited. I'm so excited. I worked so hard. I really did. I'm not gonna lie. I'm not gonna lie. Let me show you. We're in Brindleton Bay. Apparently, I have a new screen slidey thing. That's cool. What else? I'll take it. I accept. I accept. Okay, we're in Brindleton Bay. We're in the Fletcher residence. And as you can see, it's a little bit crowded, but that's because our farm animals are doubling down as doggos. So they're not really dogs, they're sheep and a goat, one goat. But right now, they're dogs, okay? They're dogs, and that's just the way it is. I've got mods galore. That's what this series is about. That's why this loading screen is taking so long. And that's why my game probably doesn't look like your game. So let's play Mod Country and see how country we can get up in this, I don't, what is, I don't know, up in this horse barn stall. Sure, yep, I'm a wordsmith. Okay, so this is my game. Welcome in, it's lovely. And if you look here, we have this farm, like picturesque or what, or what? Look at that, stunning. Absolutely stunning. I love this place. I downloaded it from the gallery, ripped out most of the landscaping, so that was definitely sad. Planted some stuff, bought some chickens. There's our goat dogs. Oh, cute farmer boy. We've got some cows in the barn. We're right, very picturesque. Very picturesque. And this house, like, it's quite something. I did add a bit in the back here, nothing really added, nothing much, just a little something to finish off the back side here. A nice lounge, if you will. Now, why don't we check on our Sims while we sort of meet our Sims? We can do a little check-in on everybody. So this is the dad, Judd. Isn't that just perfect? Judd, oh my God, I love it. Judd is about to pee his pants while sleeping, so maybe we'll just pop him in here real quick. Let's see. Judd is a perfectionist. He loves the outdoors. He's a maker. He's good. He's a farmer, and he is indifferent to being romantically exclusive, apparently. I did not know this. He's also an INTJ personality type, so imaginative and strategic thinkers with a plan for everything. So we also have a domestic trait from choosing the family aspiration of, from, wait, we're in bodybuilding and it said the family aspiration. This is not the aspiration we want. I don't think he wants to be a bodybuilder. That's not accurate. Let's fix this. He wants to be have successful lineage. He's got that John Wayne old country sort of my family legacy will go on. So that's Judd's vibe, the sort of stern type. He also needs to read to his child and socialize with his child. Speaking of children, why don't we check in on Connor here? Connor's doing a little jig in the mirror. This is not accurate. It changed all of, like, this is fine. This is fine, but it changed literally all of my aspirations. I don't know what happened. It's okay. That's perfectly fine. I think I had an aspirations mod and then maybe it got deleted. So here we are. Here we are. I'm gonna put him with nature, and I wanted him to be a botanist. I think he's interested in farming, but I think he's more so interested sort of in the nature part of things. So we're gonna fix that aspiration. Connor also is, he loves the outdoors. He's a loner, also a farmer, a good. This indifferent to romantic exclusivity thing, I think I'm gonna have to look into. That kind of shows up on all of my Sims. He's also a craftsman personality type and a collector. We'll move on to a little sister, Justina here. Justina is adventurous. ADHD personality trait. Now this one, I'm not sure if I want to keep this in. Oh no, our sheep is running away. That sucks. But yeah, if anybody is like bothered by this one, let me know. I have it in because I feel like I as long as they're not making it ridiculous and they're keeping it something that is true to what people may suffer with, like make it a little bit more relatable to people, then I'll keep it in. But if people are finding that it's, or if I'm finding that it's not, I don't know. It's not a good trait, you know? We don't want it to be necessarily a bad trait. We just want it to see if it'll affect the way our Sims sort of live as it would with a person. But yeah, let me know because right now it hasn't done anything to make me feel bad about it. Maybe it could have a different name, a different title, but we'll see how it goes. We also have our mother. Now, if you watched any of the behind the scenes, you'll notice that she looks completely different, but it's because I didn't think that she suited the personality I was thinking for her. Amira is a perfectionist. She's childish, hot-headed, a non-committal sim. She's also a maker and a champion personality type, so enthusiastic and creative and also very social. Again, we have this, but we're gonna change this for personal exclusive romantic relationships. That seems to be literally always there. Okay, his voice is kind of scary. She's also a gregarious sim. So that's a little bit of everybody in the house. Oh, I'm sure you'll get to meet them all a little bit more as we go, but it is 10 p.m. Everyone seems to be on a very strange schedule, so why don't we check on everyone, check on the animals, and just get everything going, okay? Let's do the do. So you should be asleep, and I feel like that's probably gonna take priority. So this is his room here. I'm gonna let him go to sleep. Justina is awake and shouldn't be as sad because her pet ran away, the pet being the sheep. So put her to bed. I'm gonna have Amara. Feel like Amara right now. Do I have a computer set up? I don't know if I have. I don't have an office. That seems odd for me. Okay. Why don't I may have to build an office. Did I not put a computer anywhere in this house? That seems very odd. We have this empty space here that could easily turn into an office space, so maybe we should do that. I wonder what is her aspirations? Okay, she wants to be a psychonaut, which has to do with base mental drugs. So I think we need to change hers as well. Okay, I'm gonna set hers as party animal, which I kind of want it to be a socialite. Like she wants to be a socialite, but she's kind of like, you know, that southern mom. What is it? What do they call the momstagrammers? That kind of type person. I don't know. I'm trying not to shame anybody, but also, you know, sometimes you gotta create a storyline. So that's what we're doing here. That's how we're rolling. There's a lot of food going on down here, and it's kind of stinky. Okay, so why don't we put an office in here? I don't know if I want to do an office or we need an office somewhere. That's for sure. We could always stick a small little office and desk in here. Let's do that. Oh my God, I'm also gonna change our funds because we do not have this much. We are quite wealthy. I'm not gonna lie. We're not gonna be millionaires. Maybe that's too much too. Maybe we'll go because I'm assuming our bills are gonna be quite a bit, but that'll do. That'll do. Let's throw a little office area over here. Just throw up a quick little office space here. Nothing really as spectacular at all. And I'm gonna let her go on and socialize because I feel like that's right up, sort of right up her alley. So she's gonna go online and just chat. I don't know to who, but to somebody. And I think that she should also probably put an alert out for the missing pet. I feel like she would do that because the kids are crying and sad about it. I'm not gonna lie, she's not a great mom. She's not the greatest mom. He just earned the fitness skill. He just earned the fitness skill. That seems wrong to me. Anyways, that's fine. That's fine. It is the middle of the night, and I would like to get everyone on kind of like a decent schedule, but he's like a super farmer guy. Super farmer guy. One thing that I did think that would suit his personality was if we went into base mental and if we went and had, I thought there was, okay, a nicotine addiction. I think did that work? Did that work? Let's see. Did that, I don't know if that added anything. Let's see. Okay, it did. So he is addicted to nicotine and apparently that's making him uncomfortable. So what we have to do is find a way to purchase nicotine. Okay, how can we do this? Convenience store. Okay, we have vapes. Okay, we have a pack of cigarettes. I do not condone smoking. Do not smoke cigarettes. It is bad for you. Don't do it. So our Sim is gonna buy a pack of. Oh my God, do you think he would smoke cigarettes or do you think he would smoke cigars? I think that he would be kind of like old-fashioned and smoke like cigars. So let's get two packs of cigars. Kind of intrigued by this. The items will be delivered by mail. Oh, okay. Well, that's not going to happen anytime soon, I don't think. No, get mail. Well, that's just not likely. So maybe he just came out to take care of the pets. I don't know. I guess he could do this. He could look for Easter eggs. No. What else can we do? How do we get eggs? I don't understand. Can we? Oh, I know. We need chicken feed. We had some. Oh, we have bags of it in here. Look. Let's give chicken feed and then he's going to. Where is my chicken feed? How come he can't feed the chickens? More choices. Observe the chickens? I have no idea. I don't know why he can't. We can look for Easter eggs, but I don't want an Easter egg. I just want. Okay, he's gonna have some chicken interactions here in the middle of the night before he goes to bed. Okay. Found some Easter eggs. I didn't really want Easter eggs, but that's fine. We can just hold on to those. Okay, so he's just bonding with his chickens. I'm just gonna let him do that for a little bit. Ooh, he's got charisma. I feel like his charisma would be higher, so I might do that. Put him to bed. Are you in bed? No, you're sad, but you're supposed to be in bed. Please go to sleep. Go to sleep. Oh my God, he's asleep. And she is sad, but I also want her to go to sleep. I want everyone in bed. I feel like she wouldn't care about the pet, so I'm gonna get rid of that. And that is thanks to UI cheats because you can click and get rid of and toodly doodles, things are out of there. It's a great mod. It's a good one. I don't know. I thought of doing mod reviews, but I don't know if I want to. I don't know if I would enjoy that really. I also want to do auto lights. Do we have auto lights? Auto lights, all lights. Thank you. I don't like when the lights are on. Like when they were sleeping, the lights were on. There's also some sort of really strange glitch happening with her that occasionally she develops like this really weird line connected to the earth. And I have no idea why. It's odd. It's a strange thing. I don't know what it is. Don't know what's doing it. Can't figure it out. Yay, we have dirty laundry. That's interesting. Okay, it's not good, but like that's something. It's something new. So they need a laundry basket in their room. Like I'm not pro, you know? So we need to add things as we go sometimes. Okay, we can get a nice white wicker laundry basket. We'll put that right here next to this place. No, wait, there might be better. Somewhere better? I forget what the room looks like and now the lights are turned off. Oh my God, the darkness. Oh no, we put it over here in the corner. Okay, there. No excuses. Now you can put your laundry in there. I think though, actually, everyone might be sleeping and I love that. I don't know if our dogs slash sheep are upset that they have to sleep outside, but I'm sure they're fine. We've got a sheep, Suffolk sheep, a brown goat, and a white sheep who is missing. So that's kind of unfortunate. Oh, and it's raining, so just wait for the lag to kick in. Just wait for it. It'll happen. Don't you worry. Okay, we've got somebody awake at 5 a.m. 5 a.m. I forget this child's name, Justina Fletcher. And what is she doing? Having some sort of fit. Oh, is she crying? What is this action that she is doing? I don't understand. That was very odd. I don't like that. Did she do her homework? She did not. I don't know if she would, honestly, but she woke up early and is hungry. I feel like she would have a diary, maybe. Maybe let's buy her a diary to have in her room. Oh, or maybe it's a journal. Sorry. My bad, my bad. Let's get a journal. Oh, that one's really cute. I've never seen that one. Okay, perfect. So she woke up really early and it just isn't feeling it. So she is going to express her melancholy thoughts in her journal. That's really sweet, actually. And then come downstairs and she's probably going to. I feel like she would grab a brownie for breakfast. I think she would. I think that would be what she'd go for right there. They don't have a dog, but they have dog treats. I might get rid of those because that doesn't really make any sense. Doesn't really make sense. Okay, so she's doing her thing. Is he awake too? Why is he awake so early? I guess he goes to school. Does he not go to school? I don't understand. Is he not a student? Do we have to like join school? That's weird. I'm pretty sure he's just a teenager. Okay, high school student. Perfect. Okay. That was weird, but that's fine. Thursday, class in 2 days. That doesn't seem right. Anyways, I don't know what that's about. That's odd. That's odd. We're just gonna ignore it. We're gonna ignore that. She's eating brownies in her brother's room. That's kind of an interesting one. So Jed is still sleeping. I feel like Connor would have chores before he was supposed to go to school, which apparently he doesn't have school today. Why don't you have school today? Okay, it says that they do have school today, so I don't know. I honestly don't know what it could possibly be. So is he eating right now? Where are you? Where are you eating cereal? Okay, he's eating cereal. And then I'll send him to this bathroom real quick. And then I want him to do his morning chores. So let's go in. And here's where we're at. Okay, we're gonna have to collect some hay, and then we're gonna have to feed the cows. So he'll have to do that after he gets the hay. He can't feed them until he gets it. Okay, so it says that Justina has school today in an hour. So the timing for preschool chores actually worked out really, really well. The rain is insane right now. Okay, so he's got his hay. So now he should be able to feed the cows. Oh, our goat is barking. Our goat is barking. That's a problem. We're not supposed to have barking goats. Oh no, it's a thunderstorm. Okay, all of my Sims are about to be terrified. Okay, so he fed this cow. Collect more hay. Oh, he wants to eat more cereal. Stop eating cereal. Can you feed this cow? You're gonna have to collect more hay. And then, oh, you can't get to this cow. Collect hay. Okay, we can't get to our cow. I don't know why this is a problem. We'll move our bucket. Where can we put it? We'll put the bucket, I don't know, over there. There's the bucket. Let's see if he can feed this moo cow. Please feed the moo cow. No, he can't. Is it the hay? Is the hay in the way? Poetry. Farm poetry. Dairy cow, feed the cow. Okay, yay, successful cow feeding. They can be fed again in 4 hours. Okay, and grab the milk if you could. Oh. Who is this? Wait a minute. There's a massive thunderstorm. That's intense. That's a bit intense for me. It's a bit intense in my ears. So we're gonna turn the volume down for a second. Notification wall full. Yeah, because a lot of stuff was happening. Motor skill. Okay. Justina's off to school. The mail's been delivered. That's great, Judd, on your marriage. Okay, yeah, but he married you. I'm so confused. Okay, we might have one too many mods in our game. If it's possible. If it's at all possible. Judd and Amara just became good friends. Well, that's nice because they're married. Yeah, that's good. That's good because they are married. Okay, did he get the milk from the cow? Store milk to keep it fresh. Open it to grab bottles. Oh, okay. So we can store our milk in here. We don't have to carry it around in our inventory, which is good. And we also need to grab. Oh, someone else had milk too. We want to grab a market table so that we can sell some of our stuff at the market. We have eggs too. How do we know if they're fresh? How do we tell? Open egg carton. Okay, so I guess the carton keeps them fresh. That's nifty. I'm just gonna put more seeds in his inventory right now. I feel like he would just have seed on him most of the time. I feel like I turned the volume all the way off, but the storm is really loud, guys. Like, it's really loud. I guess he's not in school today. He's just chilling and talking to his mom. I feel like she would be like, I feel like she's not super at things, you know? It's not her thing. So I feel like she would complain about the thunderstorm. And then, oh my God, scream incoherently. That's really funny. And maybe we could. Do we have parenting? Where's her? Do we have parenting stuff? Okay, a parenting influence to wash the dishes. Oh my God, give the woohoo talk. No, thank you. And I think she's a little bit mean too. I think that she would be like, you should probably do the dishes because you really like never do any work around here, even though he just came in from doing all the farm chores in a rainstorm. Like, I just feel like she's not super appreciative of things. And that's gonna be her vibe probably throughout the Let's Play. Your voice just doesn't get any better, does it? Oh my God. Yeah, she's nasty. Amara is a hothead. These Sims tend to get angry, often to the detriment of those around them. I can explain it to you, but I can't understand it for you. Oh my God, she's like super nasty. Like, super, super nasty. Okay, she is both hungry. Oh my God, you should try acting her actual age. Yeah, she's like giving it to him like real good right now. She's gonna use this. It is 10 a.m., so she's gonna use that. Then I'm gonna get her to clean up around the house. Maybe grab one of the brownies. And if we could, are we able to collect the laundry from around the house? Do laundry. Add to washing machine. That would be great. I think there's more laundry upstairs. Oh, sheep has returned. Nice. I'm glad. I'm happy for sheep. Do you think if we put dog beds in here that the sheep would sleep in them? I'm not sure. I'm not certain about it. Possibly. We have a gardener here in the middle of the rain because we do have gardeners helping with the stuff. Too uncomfortable to harvest. Yeah, well, I didn't actually want you to harvest it. I just wanted to see if it's harvestable. Okay, I'm gonna get him to. Oh my god, he can supersell everything. Supersell, please. He can also tend to the garden. Being happy makes you do things all kinds of. Oh wait, being happy makes you do better at all kinds of things. I don't know why I couldn't read that. Apparently, my brain stopped working completely. So while she's at school, why don't we have her? I feel like. She might make enemies. I don't think. I think maybe she picked up one too many traits from her mother and just isn't great with socializing yet. And her dad hasn't taken it upon himself to step in and sort of help her out in that way at all. Connor is sad because the goat ran away, but the goat came back. Like, he's back. Where's he at? I swear he was here. Hello? Where are you? Look, here's one. Sheep. Can we welcome it back? I don't know. Is that the right one? I don't remember which one ran away. Either way, you don't have to be sad about it because it's fine. So he's angry, oh, from the conversation he had. And he doesn't have school today. I don't know if he's just skipping school or what's up, but I kind of want him to go out and, oh, take a vacation day, call in sick. Okay, I'm not sure. I'm not sure, but why don't we get him to travel? He's gonna go solo dolo because apparently he doesn't have any friends. And we'll take him. Oh, Justina was copying mean to Justina at school. Apparently, we have two Justinas and one of them was being mean to the other one. I don't know who was being mean to who because they have the same name. So I don't know who I should either be mad at or feel bad for. Not sure. Not sure. I feel like, so they live here. I feel like he would maybe go because he really likes nature. I feel like he would travel maybe over to the museum just to kind of like walk around and clear his head. I think maybe that'd be one of his things. Like, he's kind of a quiet, keep to yourself type of guy. You know, he's still super bro-y and jock-like and into sports and farming and I don't, masculinity. I'm not sure. Thus far, that's the character we're at so far. He could evolve. Who knows? People change. Sims change. Okay, so he's here and it's still raining. He usually would go to walk around, but he could also go inside. Let's have him view this. This is sort of a layout of the land here, because like I said, he's interested in that eco lifestyle, yo. So have him go in there and look at some things. Can we actually go to this lighthouse, or is it just here to taunt me? Oh, he can go in the lighthouse. Okay, I'm intrigued. Go here. Show me this. Show me this. What do you do? Okay, so he goes in the house. And then what happens? So he goes in the house. And now he's up top. Oh, that is really cool. Play in the rain. There you go. Play in the rain. He went to the lighthouse to climb to the top of it and play in the rain. This is what he does just to relax and cool off, yo. I'm kind of digging it. I'm digging it. He knows how to self-care in the most unique kind of way. Oh, and he's feeling better already. Okay. Well, that's all it took. I'm gonna send him home. That was it. He's good now. He wants to do the bunny hop. Isn't. Oh my God, he's hopping around. What is he doing? What is he doing? What is that? He's hopping like a bunny. Okay, I don't know what that was, but I'm here for it. And I love it so much that I am tempted to leave it at that. I'm tempted to leave the episode there. I won't. I'm not going to. I'm gonna give you another few minutes, okay? I'm gonna give you another few. Okay, so he's home. He's hungry, like most teenagers are most of the time, I think. I'm gonna get him. Is there any leftovers in here? Get leftovers. Okay, he's gonna grab leftovers. What is Mother Dearest doing? She is socializing on the computer. I feel like since it's Thursday, maybe she would be planning an event for the weekend. So, why don't we say that she is going to be hosting just a house party? We'll start easy, okay? We're gonna start simple. We're gonna select Amira as our host. Our guests, we don't know anybody. Okay. So here's where we are going to do some cheats. Let's see. I think we can cheat at the mailbox. to get her to know more people because she would know everybody in town. This is something I should have set up beforehand and I didn't. Okay, I'm not sure how we're gonna do this. We're gonna have to actually get her to go out and get to know people, which was not exactly what I was thinking. Maybe there's another way we can get her to meet people. Let's see. One thing we could do as part of her character and to get her to meet people is actually put her on the Simda dating app. And I kind of love that for her. I feel like maybe she would have it and she wouldn't be like actively looking for dates and would kind of tell Judd because he's not really into the whole computer social media thing. I think that maybe she would tell him that it was like a social networking type of thing. So why don't we chat on the Simda chat line and we'll meet some people that way. We'll chat to Zoe Patel, Mitchell Kalani, Dominic, always down for a flirt with Dominic. Or Dominic is always down for a flirt with everybody else, I guess I should say. Okay, she's enraged. She's feeling angry. Feels like her partner is a hypocrite. Okay, another standardized test. Justina is almost done when she realizes she skipped a bubble near the top. All her answers are off by one. She starts to tell the teacher but realizes she'll have to take it again. It's really only the state. It doesn't affect her grade. I feel like she would just turn it in. I don't think she would care too much. The teacher thinks it matters a lot. She assigns extra work for the next month to ensure that Justina catches up. Okay. So she is meeting people, I think, online. She should be. Oh, I think she should also join a club. Coffee club. Oh my God, yes. Thank you. Yes, thank you. Yes, I'll be right there. Oh my God, this is it. I should have just done this right off the bat. So she's joined Coffee Club. She's also started chatting on Simda a little bit. So just as a socializing aspect, obviously she's in a committed relationship. So don't assume. Don't assume. You can assume things. It's okay. She's a terrible person. Okay, she's here at the cafe club, just throwing a hissy fit. Cardiac explosion? Hold on, hold on, hold on. Our Sim is dying. Our Sim got so mad in the first episode that she's dying of a heart attack. Hello? Like, seriously? Just like that, eh? Well, it's gonna throw a little bit of a kink in my storyline, folks. Not gonna lie. Not gonna lie. A dead sim was not in the plans for me for this very first modded episode, but you know what? We take what we're given and we work with it, and that's what we're gonna do. There's no going back. There's no going back. We're not starting from the beginning. We're not losing this whole episode of fun. Oh, she died, so we got sent back to our lot because she's the dead. Okay, cool. Well, come back for more of Mod Country. I'm sure it's gonna be a blast or a cardiac explosion. Okay, I love you. Bye.